Hello friends, let us start with our next non-traditional machining process, that is electrochemical machining, ECM. So see here the simple diagram of electrochemical machining. Here is a tool, here is a workpiece, and through this tool the electrolyte is pumping, and so by the electrolysis process this material gets dissolved and it is carried out by the electrolyte, carrying away by this splashed electrolyte. Okay, at the same time tool is given with a constant feed motion. You can see here tool is given with the negative terminal, that is it is a cathode, and workpiece is given with the positive terminal with the anode, having the low voltage and high current, direct current supply. Okay, so this is about the simple view of electrochemical machining. So what is happening here actually? So when the power supply is given to the workpiece and tool, so according to Faraday's law of electrolysis, what is happening here? The ions are displacing from the workpiece, or the workpiece is dissolving, and it will trying to deposit over the tool. Okay, it is happening here in actually electrolysis, but here the electrolyte is choose in such a fashion that the workpiece is getting dissolved, but it will not depositing over a tool. Okay, please remember, here in ECM the electrolyte is chosen in such a fashion that the workpiece material should dissolve, but it will not get deposited over the tool material. Please remember this. The order of current density and voltage, we are using the current in up to few thousand amperes, whereas the voltage in the ECM is from 8 to 20 volt. And this gap, you can see this gap between tool and workpiece is around 100 to 200 microns. Now if you look at the material removal taking place in the ECM is directly proportional to the gram atomic weight of the workpiece material, then it is directly proportional to the current density in the ECM process. Okay, but it is inversely proportional to the distance between the tool and workpiece. Again, it is inversely proportional to the density of the workpiece material. If you want to formalize that Q, that is MRR in the electrochemical machine, we can write it as Q is equal to A into I divided by rho Fz, where A is a gram atomic weight, I is the current density in the ECM process, divided by rho is the density of workpiece material, F is the Faraday's constant, that is 96500 coulombs per mole, and Z is the valency of cation. Yes or no? So this is how you can give the MRR in the ECM. Now this, see here, all the things are written here. Okay, you can have it. Now the MRR is also directly proportional to the electrical conductivity of the electrolyte. Please remember this, that is very important thing. This MRR in ECM is also proportional to what? The conductivity of electrical conductivity of electrolyte. That is, for rough mechanical process, or you can say rough machining process here, the high electrical conducting electrolyte is used. See, this is known as passivating electrolyte, please remember. And for finished machining, for finished machining, there is a low electrical conducting electrolyte is used, and that is called as non-passivating electrolyte. Please remember this. Okay, so the properties expected of the tool material in the ECMR: the high electrical and thermal conductivity, that is the tool material should have high electrical and thermal conductivity, having good stiffness, it should be easily machinable. Okay, then it should have the high corrosion resistance, right? So these are certain properties which are expected from the tool in ECM tool material. So generally aluminium, copper, brass, titanium, cupronickel, then stainless steels are used as a tool material in the ECM. Now if you look at the medium, so medium in this process is what? The conducting electrolyte, and preferably the electrolyte is a salt solution. Okay, so if you look at the electrolyte, what are the function that be carried out by this electrolyte are? So first thing, it should control the electrical circuit between the tool and workpiece, or you can say it should complete the circuit between the tool and workpiece. Next important function of electrolyte, that it should allow the desirable machining reaction to take place so that material removal improve. It should carry away the heat generated in the process as well as the chips which are produced in the process. Okay, then what are the properties of electrolyte? So it should have high electrical conductivity, low viscosity and high specific heat. It should be chemically stable. It should not form any toxic fumes or toxic environment, and it should be non-corrosive. And of course, it should have a low cost and easily available. So these are the properties of electrolyte used in the ECM process. Now wear ratio is infinite, says there is no variant here of the tool, so definitely wear ratio will be infinity. Okay, so if you look at the advantages of ECM, we can machine the complex three-dimensional surfaces very easily by using the ECM. As there is no wear and tear of the tool, the same tool can be produce a number of components or many components. And as there is no direct contact between tool and workpiece, so no any forces or residual stresses induced, okay, in the tool as well as in the workpiece. So next is, the process does not thermally affect the workpiece, so there is no any effect of heat on the workpiece. Now what are the limitations of ECM? So out of all unconventional machining method, ECM require highest specific cutting energy. Please remember, that is only one limitation of ECM, that it is required very high specific cutting energy. What is meant as specific cutting energy? That is the work done in the metal cutting divided by volume of material removed, that is MRR. Okay, so work done divided by MRR is known as highest specific cutting energy. As here specific cutting is highest, that means is what? The Q will be lower for a given material. So here workpiece must be electrically conductive, right? And it is generally preferred for producing the contour surfaces. Sharp corners are not possible to produce in the electrochemical machining process. Okay, what are the applications of ECM? So ECM is mainly used for producing the complex shapes in turbine blades. It's very important application of ECM. Turbine blades are machined by using the electrochemical machining process. Now the extension of this, you can have the next process, that is the ECG, that is electrochemical grinding. So basically this process is suitable for the regrinding of the carbide tools. Okay, so here the process is a combination of electrochemical and grinding operation. and the gap between the tool and workpiece is mainly controlled by the C, abrasive size, abrasive particles present in the on the grinding wheel. So how this gap between the tool and workpiece is maintained? By using the size of the abrasive particle present on this grinding wheel. Okay, so this see this thicker layer is abrasive particles. This is the electrical conductive grinding, and here we are providing the flow of electrolyte. This is our workpiece. Okay, so the application is very famous application used for grinding of very hard workpiece like carbide cutting tools are regrind by using the electrochemical grinding process. So now we'll see the chemical machining, right? So in chemical machining, what are the steps involved in the chemical machining? Now electrochemical grinding is over here. Actually, this is now little bit I will talk you about the chemical machining, which is also known as chemical milling also. Okay, so chemical machining or chemical milling is a process used to dissolve the workpiece material in chemical solution. Okay, therefore the part not to be dissolved would have to be applied with the mask which resists the chemical action of a solution. Okay, so basically here we are going to dissolve the material. So where we want the material removal, we will expose that material only to the chemical action or to the chemical solution, and rest of the thing we will cover with something like coating, which is known as the mask. Okay, we will apply the mask over it, so that portion will not get dissolved. Okay, that will be remain as it is, and where we want to do machining, that will be exposed to the chemical solution. That is the idea behind this chemical milling or machining. So let us see what are the steps in the chemical machining. So basically you have to clean the workpiece thoroughly to ensure that the masking material will adhere to the workpiece. Why to clean? So that wherever you want to put the masking material, it should stick to that workpiece properly. Okay, then apply a chemical resistant mask on the workpiece surface where no material to be removed. Where you don't want any material anymore, you just apply this chemical resistant mask or coating. Then dip the workpiece into the chemical solution, which is known as etchant. Okay, and leave for a sufficient time to get necessary depth of etching. How much material removal you want, based on that you put that workpiece material into the solution, which is known as etchant, until you get the required depth of etching. Then remove the mask after having the etching. Then remove the mask and clean the workpiece. During etching process, the material removal takes place in depth wise, right? In the unexposed portion as well as in the inward direction under the mask. Please remember what is happening here. During the etching process, the material removal, or here the dissolve, you are getting in the exposed portion as well as where you have applied the mask. Underneath of this mask also you will get some material removal. So the distance which is etched under this mask is known as the undercut. See here. So here, see here, so this is the workpiece and you want machining only in this portion, and that's why you have applied the mask over it. Okay, but what I say here, during etching process, the removal takes place in depth wise direction. See, this is the depth. Okay, where you have not exposed this where you have actually exposed this to the chemical solution. Okay, here you don't want machining, that's why you have provided mask here. So what I just said here, this unexposed portion also having some itching, okay, in inward directions here. This is the itching occurred here, right? So this is known as, or this distance, this distance itched under this mask. See, this is mask. This distance itched under this mark is known as the undercut. Okay, so here you will get some factor here that is known as itch factor, which is the ratio of this undercut, this undercut divided by this depth of cut. Okay, so please remember this itch factor is what? The undercut divided by depth of cut. So what are the applications of this chemical machining or milling process? You can use in the aerospace application this process. The components of complex profiles, right, in very thin metals used in the instrumentation. Then it can also do engraving any type on the metal. The main advantage of the process is that a large number of workpiece can be simultaneously machined, which can improve the productivity. That is the thing. Simultaneously, you can have number of workpieces can be do machining, so that productivity is improving or increasing. And next is requires a little capital investment for the basic equipment, and tooling cost is less, so economic way it is very good or cheap machining process, right? So this is about the chemical machining or milling process. So in this video we will stop here. Next video we will start EDM process. Thank you.